Hi everyone, today we are working on hand lettering plus shadow work. This is a technique that I learned when I was younger in my school days, and I was observing a kid and he was very good at it, and I was so impressed. I was just observing him and I don't even know his name, but I was observing in him what he was doing. And I was so fond of the work he created that I started practicing it. I understood how he was working on the letters. And then I was so much in love with it that today I wanted that I should share it with you. It is so easy and it involves some physics. Not literally. But yes, let's get started. So if we talk about the shadow work, it means that if there is a shadow, it means there is an object and there is a source of light. So if I talk about that, this is an object and here is the shadow of the object, I mean direction wise. Here is the shadow on its left or right. It means on the opposite side is the source of light. Similarly, if this is an object and its shadow is created at this particular angle, it means the source of light is here, right? Then I can say that if the shadow is at this side and an object is here, then the source of light must be here, right? Now we will learn how to write letters, alphabets, and create their shadows thinking about the source of light. So I have written these letters and these words for you, and we will create shadows for these objects. So we will consider these letters as objects and we will keep in mind a particular angle for the source of our light and we will create the shadow accordingly. So I'm starting with this A. Now if I have considered that shadow is on this side, it means it will be, for all the words, it will be this side. For the complete letter, it will be this side and this. So you can identify the shadow here. I'll use some other color to create a shadow because it is not correctly visible. So as you can see, I've kept the shadow for this horizontal line here. So for each horizontal, I've kept the shadow. It means the letter is placed on this surface. That is why it is creating shadow like this. On the top, there is no shadow. On the right, there is a shadow. On the right, there is a shadow. At the bottom, there is a shadow. At the bottom, there is a shadow. Similarly, we'll go for next letter B. So, like this, we have a shadow here. Similarly, like this here and here. Here and here. We'll go for letter C now. Half of the shadow will be here and half of the shadow will be here and here. Then for D, it will be like this. At the bottom, again half of the shadow we will create on the upper part and half we will create on the lower part. Like this. Then for E, it is very simple. Like this, like this, like this, this, and this, this. So you can see here how the gray part appears to be as a 3D part. It is placed like a block here, and this block is creating shadow like this. Similarly, I'll go for the word shine. Like this and then this, and then like this, and then this. H like this, I like this. This. You have to keep in mind where you are keeping shadows and where is the source of light. It should be same across the complete word. Bright. Like this. Like this, 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 and this. Like this, here we go. Similarly for light, this. Like this, like this. On our right we are making the shadows, at the bottom we are making the shadows, like this. On the right, at the bottom, like this. At the bottom, on the right, like this. What we can also do is, we can create a word using only shadows. It will appear that only shadow will form a word. So we will write some words like I. So you can see that here I'm keeping on the above and on the right of the imaginary block of letter I that I have kept in my mind, and it is placed here. So it will create an illusion that a word, a block of letters is kept here. I'm sure you are able to read these words. I'm happy. And you are able to understand because there is a symmetry in the pattern of the shadow which is being created. If I write, hat. Or hate. So here I am saying that the source of light is coming from this direction, because the source of light is coming from here, that is why the shadow is created on the opposite side. If you'll see that the light is coming from left bottom, so the shadow will appear on the right top. I hope you understand this and you really like this technique. Please let me know how you find it. Please let me know if you have tried it. Let me know. Please let me show your work and exchange ideas. Thank you for watching AJ Crafts, Crafting with AJ. Please do not forget to like, share and comment on our videos. Make sure you have subscribed this video and keep in touch for more craft ideas. Thank you so much.